Now, when we are still on the subject of defining a great mix, there are also some technical aspects which we need to know, besides the concept which I explained before. So, the technical aspects of a great mix are the following. A great mix has covered the whole frequency spectrum from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. This means that all the sounds you are using for your arrangement should cover the whole frequency spectrum. You should not have just sounds who are playing in the higher mid-range around, let's say, 3 kHz, but you should have sounds which are placed all around the spectrum. You can, for example, take a spectrum analyzer and put it on your master channel and then see your track, compare it to a commercial track and see if you have holes in the frequency spectrum. And for example, if you have a hole at, let's say, 1 kHz over a huge amount of your track, then you can look for new sounds in your production process which fills exactly this frequency spectrum. For example, you can look for a pad sound or for a filter sweep which is playing around 1K, and then it will fit perfectly in the arrangement. Then the next step is that we should cover the whole stereo image. Since we have a complete stage from left to right, we should place our elements in the complete stereo spectrum. I can show you some nice examples how you place them in the stereo field. And what's also a great concept is if you imagine if your track is being played at a stage. For example, think about a rock band. A rock band which is standing on a stage, they have the drummer probably in the middle, they have the lead vocal which are in the front, they have the lead guitar number one front left, they have lead guitar number two front right, then they have some keys standing a little bit behind the lead guitarist. And maybe they have a bass player standing in the back, but the bass amp will probably be centered behind the drums. And this is a concept which you can think of how you want to have placed your sounds in your arrangement on your stage. This can mean that you make the bass line centered. Of course, you can have a stereo bass line, but the low end should be, in my opinion, be monoed out. I'm going to show you some techniques how you do this later. Then you have a snare, which should always be centered in my opinion. Then you have the hi-hats, the open hats, the closed hats. And there, for example, I like to pan them a little bit left and right. Not hard, so just maybe 20% the hi-hat number one, 20% to the right. Hi-hat number two, 20% to the left. Then you have a tambourine, which you make 30% to the right. Then you have a hi-hat playing on the 1, 2, 3 beat you have centered, and that's a way which you can spread your hi-hats in a nice way. Then you should have your main lead sounds, like in psytrance. I would say you can do everything which works. Personally, I would say don't get too crazy and always have contrast, because if you have an arrangement where everything is crazy arranged around the stereo field, it can be a little bit too much for your ear to detect everything, which can be a nice psychedelic sound since we are in psychedelic music, everything is allowed. But personally, or you need to think that if you have everything in mono and then you have just one sound which is playing in the stereo field, it will appear much more impressive to you because you have the contrast. So always think about the contrast. Then we also need to decide if a sound will be appear in the front or in the back. How do we achieve it? Sounds in the front are louder, they have more high frequency, they have less reverb with more early reflections. And sounds in the background are quieter, they have less high frequency. You can use a high shelf equalizer to tame the highs. And they have more reverb with less early reflections, and they are more mono, because if a sound is far away, your ear cannot detect so well if it's right or left. And if a sound is, if somebody stands exactly behind your face and he's speaking, you clearly detect if he's coming more from the right side or from the left side or from the center. So keep these concepts in mind. Then next thing, a good mix have great balance between all the elements. which you simply need to check on as many different speakers as possible. Simply look if the low mids are right or if the high mids are right, if there are elements too loud or too quiet. Compare your track to a lot of commercial tracks. Always important, compare it to very well produced music and always compare it at the exact same perceived volume. Then the next thing I mentioned before, always have contrast. It's, in my opinion, very important. Have contrast between quiet passages and loud passages. Have contrast between passages where there's a lot of stuff happening, where there's not much happening. Have contrast between stereo image. There are sounds which are clearly mono, sounds that are clearly in the stereo field. Have a clear hierarchy between sounds which are important and sounds which are not important. And the sounds which are important, you polish up a lot, you make them sounding great with a lot of sparkle, a lot of presence. And sounds which are not important, you make quiet, you make not so much high frequency, you just add them a little bit in the background to enhance the important sounds. And another thing which is important to know is you always need to avoid frequency masking. Frequency masking means if two elements are playing at the exact time and they are sharing the exact same frequency range, this need to be avoided. How do you avoid it? The best thing would be if you avoid it by arranging the sound in a more intelligent way, which for example mean instead of let them play at the same time, make question and answer themes. Or if this doesn't work for your arrangement, you can try to put one sound one octave up, the other one an octave down. Or you can try to pan one element more to the left, the other one more to the right. Or you can try to solve it by equalizing. For example, on sound number one, you boost the low mids and make a dip in the high mids. On the second sound, you make the opposite. And this way you can find ways to avoid frequency masking. I think these are the most important things to know how you get a great mix.